Welcome to The Journey. Today we're going to talk about how to create a lead generator for your business. Find leads, they said. It'll be easy, they said. Well, if you've ever tried tackling lead generation for your website, you know that this is not the case. Aggressive sales pitches and commercials were effective a few years ago. I recall them, but having quality content is becoming more important to engage customers.
Your audience no longer wants you to buy their attention. They want you to earn it. This means if you want ongoing work, you need to attack lead generation with a diversified list of methods. But why do you actually need lead generation? Well, when a potential client is looking for something that they need and your website distinctly grabs their attention, the chances of conversion shoot up sky high automatically.
Lead generation is a must to stay competitive in this market. It also contributes to a better return on investment by being the cheapest direct marketing method. A quality and funneled lead generation process will definitely make it easier on both the client and the business side of things, getting exactly what they need online.
Online lead generation encompasses a wide range of tactics, campaigns, strategies, depending on the platform on which you wish to capture the leads. But what channels should you use to promote your landing page? Let's talk about the front end of lead generation, lead gen marketing. One of the best ways to generate leads through your website is through the actual content of the website itself. It's a great way to guide users to a landing page. Typically, you create content to provide your visitors with useful, free information such as an ebook or an exclusive video series or email series, something that you can give them that adds value to them. What I do as a web designer is I'll create dedicated landing pages for whatever free value I'm offering through lead generation. Usually it's either a consultation or that little ebook checklist series of like optimizing your website. But I use that to delight my visitors with that free value. And in return, they're paying me with their contact information that I can use to start adding into my own marketing funnel.
Let's talk about blogs. I love blogs. And the great thing about using your blog post to promote an offer is that you can actually tailor the entire piece to the end goal. So let's do an example. Let's say, for example, you offer an instructional video about how to make some pizza. Then you can write a blog post about that, how to make the best deep dish pizza in your own kitchen, which would make your CTA, your call to action, highly relevant and easy to click.
You can also use social media to generate leads for your business. So social media platforms make it super easy for a visitor to take action on a post, from the swipe up option on Instagram stories to Facebook bio links to even bit.ly URLs, so it's shorter to click on Twitter. But you can promote your offerings on social media posts and include a call to action to those landing pages or offer forms or even just the offer itself.
Ads and retargeting. What's that about? Well, the sole purpose of ads and retargeting is to get people to take action, right? Otherwise, why spend the money? And if you want people to convert, be sure that your landing page and the offer match exactly what is promised. Ooh, that drives me nuts when that's not the case. And then that the action you want the users to take is crystal clear.
And let's start to jump into some of the different strategies that go behind lead generation. Now, online lead generation encompasses a wide range of tactics, campaigns, and strategies, really depending on the platform on which you use to really capture those leads. Whatever channel that you use to generate leads, you'll want to guide users to your landing page. As long as you built a landing page that converts, the rest will handle itself. So Emma and I are going to break down some of the different lead generation tactics. Emma, take it away.
All right. Thanks for the tee up, Neely. Be sure you link your CTA to a dedicated landing page. Now, you might be thinking, hey, this is super obvious, but you'd be surprised how many marketers don't create a dedicated landing page for their offers. Now, CTAs, again, call to actions, are meant to send the visitors to a landing page where they can receive a specific offer.
And please, please, please don't use these call to actions just to link people to your homepage. There's way too much going on your homepage, too many directions to go to. It's not focused. Even if your CTA is about your brand or product, perhaps not even offer at all, like a download, you should still be setting them to a targeted landing page that's relevant to what they're looking for and include an opt-in form too. And if you have the opportunity to use a CTA, send them to a page that will convert them into a lead versus just letting them run around the playground of your website and hope they end up in your marketing funnel.
Also, be sure to utilize SEO for your website. So search engine optimization, lead generation is all about identifying potential customers for your services or your wonderful products. And lead generation in the 21st century should include SEO. Absolutely. By optimizing your website with the right keywords, you can not only attract visitors, more customers, you can attract qualified visitors. So with the right SEO approach, you can attract qualified leads. And if you have the time and desire, you can go the DIY, do-it-yourself approach and save some money.
And the thing I love about SEO is that it's an even playing field. I mean, sure, your competitors might be able to invest more into SEO, but they can't buy themselves into the number one spot for organic results. But SEO isn't exactly known for being a quick process. Depending on the keywords you're targeting, it could take 6, maybe 12 months to start seeing significant progress. Now, keyword research and content creation can prove to be quite time consuming if you're managing it all yourself. So if you opt to hire an SEO specialist instead, check out the video that we did on that.
And bring in local leads by targeting your region. Google's priority is to generate trustworthy, accurate search engine results for its users. And while distance might not be a factor for some business types, clients often trust and prefer a local business. I know I do.
It's a great point. And you'll also want to make sure that you look at your site's conversion strategy. So what happens after a visitor lands on their page? There's no point in driving leads to your websites if they don't convert. First names, last names, phone numbers, emails, you want it all. Get it by offering something they want. Like, think about your target audience. What problems do they have? And what piece of content that you can create to help them solve their problems? And it might be even content that you've already created. What I like to do is repurpose a blog post and make it into an ebook. That way it's not a lot of heavy lifting with me, but I can see that the awesome blog post that I had that has one of the highest number of visitors is helping out my audience. So I'll create a little lead gen there. But whatever that is, you want to make sure that it's solving their problems. But perhaps further down the sales funnel, they are ready to contact you directly. Make it easy as pie with a strategically placed call to action. On our website, we have CTAs on almost every page with copy that encourages you to contact us for help and support. But when you build a website around conversion, your website stops being a brochure and starts being a sales funnel. You'll also notice a decrease in bounce rates as well because your site's optimized to get them to that next point in time with your website.
Yeah, so be sure to keep track of your contacts in a CRM. This is important. Once you're generating leads, congrats, you want to make sure that you keep them organized. You don't have to shell out a ton of money in order to do this, but you know, upgrade from those Excel spreadsheets. But there's actually a number of very reasonably priced CRMs.
And last here, you want to make sure that your messaging is consistent and you deliver on your promise. The highest converting lead gen campaigns are the ones that deliver on what they promised and create a seamless transition from ad copy and design to the deliverable itself. Make sure you're presenting a consistent message throughout the entire process that provides value to everyone that engages with your lead capture.
So like Neely said, making sure that your messaging is consistent. So just make sure all your aspects of your lead gen match up on your website and your blog and within your product.
But hey, Rome wasn't built in a day. It's okay to take your time and get it just right. Business expansion is directly connected to finding new clients and making them happy. Let's face it, you won't have customers without leads in the first place. This is why lead generation plays an important role in the digital age. With great lead generation strategies, you'll have potential customers, and as a result, you'll be making money. It's as simple as that.
All right, that's a wrap. You just learned how to create a lead generator for your business. Be sure to like this video and comment below.
And while you're there, make sure you subscribe to this channel and ring that bell so you get these episodes first. This is The Journey. We'll see you next time.